Hey guys, welcome to the video. So basically this is going to be a tutorial on how to sync up an acapella and an instrumental file. Okay, you can find acapellas and instrumentals on the Bobby Trill and Dank Hill channels that we have here, but it really doesn't matter where you get them from. It can come from any variety of sources. Now, I know what you're all probably thinking, and yes, that is me in the upper left face cam. Now, I know what it looks like. Blunt, red eyes, right? I'm probably high as shit, right? No. It's actually 5 a.m. and I'm tired, but I really wanted to get this video out to help anyone who comes across this channel and be able to give them the tools to use the content that they find here. Because whether you grab the files from other websites or here, they're going to end up being different links. They're not going to line up perfectly when you lay them on top of each other, okay? So, just to be clear, an acapella is the vocals of a song without the beat, and an instrumental is the beat of a song without the vocals on top of it. They're separated tracks. Alright, I also wanted to explain why I'm in a video editor right now and not a DAW like you might expect, like Fruity Loops or Pro Tools or something like that. Basically, this tutorial is geared at people who are maybe you're trying to make a TikTok, maybe you're trying to do some basic editing, maybe you don't know a lot about audio engineering or music production or anything like that. You just want a basic idea on how to line these things up so you can work with them and have some fun. If you have a DAW and you know how to do things in there, the techniques you're going to learn here are still going to apply. It's visual and audio based, looking at the waveforms of the file and listening to hear and make sure everything's lined up properly. Now, in order to do this, we're going to need three things. You're going to need the acapella from your song, the instrumental of your song, and the original song in its entirety, both the acapella and the instrumental collapsed, which basically would just be the song you would find like it was on iTunes or YouTube Music or Spotify. So the big reason we're doing this is when you download an acapella or an instrumental, whether it's from other websites or sources or from the Bobby Trill and Dank Hill channels, the files aren't always going to be the same length. They're always not always going to line up right. So we need to go in and manually adjust things. So let's go ahead and get into it. The first thing I'm going to show you is the original song we're going to be working with here. I chose Juice WRLD's I'll Be Fine because it's just a banger of a track. I'm going to go ahead and play that just so you can hear it real quick what it sounds like together if you don't already know it. I'ma be fine, but in the meantime, bitches lean time, Papa Bean time, cause they ain't killing me. My love bro keep a 40, they thought his ass was security. Too busy making money to worry about making memories, but in the meantime. So we have that. Next, I'm going to show you the beat of the song without the acapella on top of it. Alright, dope. And finally, I'm going to show you the acapella without the beat on top of it. I'ma be fine, but in the meantime, bitches lean time, Papa Bean time, cause they ain't killing me. My love bro keep a 40, they thought his ass was security. Too busy making money to worry about making memories. Okay, so we got all that together. Now, let's say we have our beat and we have our vocals here. Let's go ahead and play them together because I want to show you that they're not lined up right. When the two are not lined up right, you're not going to see it necessarily, but you'll definitely notice it. It might still sound okay because they'll have the same tempo and will still be progressing at the same pace. However, it's going to sound kind of off, okay? And you're going to understand once you hear this here. So as you can hear, you know, it sounds like okay, I guess, you know, it almost sounds kind of like, you know, a remix or an alternate version of the song. However, it is still off and it's not really on beat and it's not as satisfying as if the vocals were to hit at the same time as the beat, just like we have in the original. So the first thing we're going to do in order to accomplish this, we're going to try and line up our instrumental with the original track. And then after that, we're going to line up the acapella to the original track and the instrumental together. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to try to line up the beat with the original track. And we're going to do this visually. If you take a look at here, these actually already look kind of similar. See, we have this like lower section here, kind of slopes up into this whole big section. And I can already tell just looking at this, this is our 808 and our kick together, and this is a section without it. That's why it looks so big and fast, because that's just a nice big bass wave coming through. And it's not going to look exactly the same, so the original track, is the waveform is going to be the beat and the acapella waveforms mashed together in order to make this, but they'll still have the same general shape and you'll be able to pick things out. So if I were to go ahead and scoot this over, you'd see we already kind of lined up a little bit. We're going to zoom in. You want to get as close as you can. So when we do this, we're generally looking for a kick or a snare or something that's like kind of pronounced and easy to pick out. We have this kick right here, but it's in the middle of an 808, so it's not quite as pronounced as it normally would be. This kick right here, as you can tell, it's coming right after this kind of a bit of silence, so it's really pronounced. We can go ahead and try to line this up. And if you look at over here, we even have this little section right here, this little like dip into a thing, into all these little dips and clips. We have another one right here that just keeps going. We're going to go ahead and try and get these scooched together. But this already looks pretty good, if I'm honest, just from that initial one. So we'll leave it right there for now. I'm not going to play them together. Actually, you know what? I will. Because you don't want to. But I want you to hear what it sounds like anyway, so you know why you don't want to. When these play together, if it was just the melodies, it'd be okay. But when the basses are going together like that, it's just gonna get muddy as shit and it's gonna be a good time. So let's check it out real quick. So there you go. Now you know how to make those really distorted videos. What is it, like nuked memes or something? But anyway, so we have those going together. We're gonna mute our beat and pull out the acapella here. And if we take a look at the acapella, let me search around, try and find a little part here. Okay, so I found a part here that we can line up in the audio. So I actually scooted the beat down to our bottom track here. I made sure I held shift in this program so it didn't scooch around anywhere while I did it. So if you take a look here, we have this little, what are we gonna call it, a bump here, as well as into this big old shape going through over here. And if we look, we have a bump right here. And we have the rest of the big old shape going. So what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing we did with the other one. We're going to line these two up. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to shorten this clip so we have a little bit more room to work with and then extend it back out later. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to line up these two really big spikes, not really big, but these two decent sized spikes in the volume, because those are going to be the easiest to line up rather than trying to do a general shape. We go and scoot that over, and it looks like I actually might have cut out the perfect amount at the beginning. I go ahead and take my mouse and move it straight down as close as I can. It looks to be about lined up. Okay, so with the vocals, you can actually do this from an auditory perspective. It doesn't necessarily have to be purely visual. If you did it purely visual, you'd probably end up being slightly off. What we're going to do, we're actually going to play the vocals with the original song. Okay, if the vocals are lined up properly, it'll sound exactly the same as the original, except the vocals will sound louder. If it's off, it'll sound kind of like, I don't know how to describe it, almost like there's two of them, or it's kind of like a really big voice. It's hard to describe, but if you heard it, you'd know it.
But in the meantime, bitch is green time, maybe lean time, add energy, mama.
Okay, and as you can hear there, it sounds like the regular song, but Juice is just really, really loud in this case. And I'm gonna play it back one more time and take him in and out so you can hear the difference.
Lean time, bitch is green time, maybe lean time, add energy, my mama told me stop the painkillers, them shits is killing me.
Okay, so as you heard there, I took him out for a second, the volume dipped down, I brought him back and went back up. I am going to go ahead and make it just a little bit off so you can hear what it sounds like if it's off.
I'm gonna be fine. I just popped a bean yesterday, it was a long night. I didn't do the right drugs, only on the wrong night. I was rocking on white, trying to have a fun time.
Okay, so as you could hear there, it's almost lined up, but not quite. That's why it sounds so, I really don't know what the word is, buzzy? I don't know, but you get what I'm getting at here. Basically, you want to get that effect minimized as much as possible. Okay, when you get it lined up, it'll sound perfectly smooth, like nothing's different. If you go too far, it'll sound like that again, just going the other way, basically. So now that we have this all lined up here, I'm going to go ahead and play it together with our beat and just make sure that we're on. Alright, got the originals muted, so let's go ahead and see what it sounds like.
I'ma be fine, but in the meantime, bitches lame time, Papa Bean time. Cause they ain't killing me, my lil' bro keep a 40, they thought his ass was security. Too busy making money to worry about making memories. But in the meantime, bitches green time, maybe lean time, out of energy. My mama told me stop the painkillers, them shits is killing me. I'ma be fine. I should pop the bean. Yesterday it was a long night.
Okay, and as you can hear, it sounds just like our original track. Okay, so one thing I do want to mention is when I was doing this, as you saw, it's really, really zoomed in, which is ideal for trying to line things up. However, if you're new to this and you're not the best at picking out the shapes between the different waveforms, it might be easier to zoom out a little bit and then zoom in. For example, if we zoom out here, we can see the general shapes a lot more than when we're zoomed in. For example, right here, we can tell this is when it's quieter, and then right here, that hard line right there, that's where the bass hits, and as we can see it down here in the beat, there's that hard line where it hits again. We have this shape right here, which is the beginning of the vocals before that bass hits, and there they are again. So what you can do is find them, line up to them, then zoom in on them and try to line it up. And as you can see, you can start to see all the different little details and try and get those together. The other thing too is, as you can see, I'm working with the clip here, this isn't the full song, obviously. So what we're going to do now that we have it all taken care of, I'm going to turn the magnet on, make sure everything's all nice and lined up perfectly, nice. I'm going to take it, scoot it over, extend it out, there's the beginning of our tracks. And if we go ahead and do it one more time, that's the whole song in its entirety right there. And one thing, I'm pretty sure these are, yep, they look to be about perfect, yep. They're the same file length, so the fact that these are lining up so well and it's giving me that red line, meaning that's the end of it, except for the first one, which has a little bit of extra silence at the beginning. I can tell that I did this right. You won't have that knowledge if these files are different lengths and you don't have what I know, where I know they're already lined up right. But you're really just gonna have to take it by ear. So some of you may be asking, why would I want to do this? You know, if I'm just gonna line up the beat with the acapella and just play it through its entirety, then why don't I just grab the original song where I already know it's lined up? Well, you know, like I mentioned before, you know, sometimes you want to do remixes, maybe you want to play with it a little bit. One good example would be maybe you want the beat to play, keep playing without the vocals to give a different effect, maybe an outro. I have an example right here that I can show to you guys. Alright, this is using a song by, I believe it's Yeet, Y-E-A-T. I did this for my brother recently. Basically, using this technique, I was able to line everything up here in the DAW. I'm not going to show you that process because I already know it's set, and I'm going to play it for you real quick so you can hear it as well. So here that goes.
He does it. Stuck in the mix, mix feels it cause I love it. 45 seconds to win it, who does it? Yeah, and it's way too far, gonna save that shit, I won't touch it.
Okay, and just like I was mentioning before, you can have parts where you take out the acapella in order to give kind of an outro. This was for a TikTok. And I wanted it to loop perfectly, but if I had the vocals going all the way, it would have been weird. So if I started from here. See, it's not quite as smooth as if I had it cut off here. Alright, in addition, I was also able to make a little bit of a transition here between the quieter part and the bigger part, which also I was able to grab the quieter part and remix it a little bit to get something different from the original song. If I didn't have a separate instrumental than the acapella, then they'd be combined, and whatever I do to the beat would be done to the vocals too, and you don't always want to do that. For example, here I chopped it up three times. It's basically the start of the bass. I chopped it up three times and put it right after each other for the transition, so that after the quiet part ends, it goes boom, 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 and it turns into a whole nother thing. I'll play that one more time for you. So yeah, like I said, this is just an example of kind of what you can do with this. The possibilities really are endless. Maybe you want to take this and line up your own vocals to it, rap over the beats, do whatever. Really, the world is your oyster on this one. That's the tutorial. If you apply these techniques, whether it's in a DAW like I got here, or it's within a video editor like this, you'll be able to do the same thing and get all these acapellas and vocals lined up for your own uses, whatever that use might be. Hope you learned something new today. Hope you can apply this in your own projects. And I hope you have a nice one. Take care.